It's your boy,
Benny Band. Yeah. Benny Band.
Yeah.
Benny Band.
Yeah.
It's the culture show. It's the culture show. Culture show. Benny Band.
Today, I got Cincinnati's own Dave Dillenger.
What's up, people? It's your boy again, Benny Bands, the host for the Culture Show. I'm here with comedian Dave Dillenger out of Cincinnati, Ohio, man. What's going on, Playboy?
How you doing, man?
Going all right,
nice
man.
To meet you,
hey, man. Went up here today, tore the stage down, you know what I'm saying? Hey, man, I want that one to ask you, what you about to? What's it about to? You about to smoke?
I mean, I know you're
nah, right. Nah, about to, is but when the weed's so good, you ain't about to do shit. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you about to do that day, you about to do it. You ain't about to do shit.
That's a
that shit that good, boy. Yeah. You better say it. You better say it. Shit, I was about to be on time. I was
no
late
doubt.
Today, shit.
No doubt, no doubt. And he is part of Ovation's family, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
You know, hey Jay, what's up, baby? You know what I'm saying? I know you're doing other things right now, but other than, you know what I'm saying, coming down, moving the stage up, man, what else you got going on for yourself, bro?
I've been moving around, man, trying to stay away from this COVID.
Now I'm sick.
Yeah, my bad. I try to shoot it over here, get the table sick.
Right.
Other than that, man, I got shows coming up, man. We're trying to stay busy doing this turmoil and all this shit, mm-hmm. But yeah, I got we got a Valentine show coming up. I'll be back down here. March the 5th. Yeah.
March the 5th.
So I'll be down here. I'll be in Louisville.
Louisville, you said, man.
Luther Chauncey.
Luther
if
Chauncey.
Y'all know that nigga, you know what I mean? That's where the fuck I'm gonna be with.
He said it like, you know what I'm saying? He owes some money.
Y'all might know him, you know what I'm saying? But if y'all know him, I'm gonna be on his show.
Right.
The Laughing Post is dope, man. I mean, it's a beautiful venue, man. Beautiful people. Everybody that's been around tonight is awesome. So hopefully I can come back, man, and, you know, spread some laughter or whatever. So it was dope. I got a whole lot of weight for this. It was like, you want to go hiking? I was like, hell no. Nah. I got T-Mobile, nigga. I don't trust my phone, so hell no. I'm not going to do that shit. I'll be the last nigga on the movie. Like, that nigga died like a motherfucker. Hell no. Nah. I ain't doing none of that shit.
So how long you been doing comedy?
Man, I'm about 10 years in here, man.
10 years in.
Yeah.
You love it?
Yes. I wouldn't do nothing else.
Nothing else.
Hell no, I'll trade that shit for child support.
So if they came and offer you a movie right now, you gonna turn it down.
Man, I'll knock them down. If they offer me a movie for it, I'll move Jesus out the ring. Excuse me, Lord, I'm about to win. Yes. Sign me up tonight.
Tonight. So speaking of movies, you know, would you like to be in any movies, anything like that? Is that something that's part of your plan, you know?
Yeah, I think movies, yeah, absolutely. I did a couple bootleg movies,
bootleg movies.
I could say that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They ain't make it to Hollywood, but they was dope.
It was dope.
Yeah, definitely. Acting is detrimental.
Detrimental. So in your comedy journey, did you just pick up a mic, or did you have some type of formal training, or you was always naturally funny? You know, what's the curve?
I started
out,
I was this weed kicking in. Always been a class clown.
Right, like and, most comedians.
Yeah, so one day my dude asked me to go to the Funny Bone in Cincinnati.
Mm-hmm.
I always wanted to do it, so I was excited, like, all right, come on.
Right.
So he had a cousin from Atlanta that went to an open mic. He was horrible. He lost. So I'm sitting in the back. I'm like, man, I could do that.
Right.
I could do that.
Yeah.
I signed myself up, and I won.
And you win.
And I never stopped.
And you never stopped.
Yep. That's really how I got started.
That's what's up, man.
Because, you know, everybody is a class clown or living room comic or
my favorite
uncle. Like, oh, my cousin.
Mm-hmm.
Nah. I decided to go further with it, and I love it.
Loved it.
I'm loving it.
So in your comedy journey, man, have you ever run across any bad promoters that try to play you in your check or anything like that?
All the time. Niggas, y'all, first of all, Laughing Post, the only motherfuckers that pay me right now. Okay? Everybody else, how you gonna email some money? No. I need my cheese, bro. For real. It's only a few real people that'll pay you what you're worth. and exactly the way, you know what I'm saying? They just give it to you. Not all this bullshit.
Why you think promoters be trying to play you out of pocket like that, man, or comedians out of pocket like that? What is the purpose behind that?
Because they smoking that bow too. They was about to figure out where the money at. They was about to worry about, man, fuck all that, nigga.
Right.
We don't
right.
smoke that shit. We smoke right now. That's what the fuck we smoke. No.
No, hell right. no. I feel that, man. What's some of your goals that you're trying to reach out of this comedy?
What I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to be successful. I have a son. I'm trying to leave a legacy. I'm trying to leave something he can live off of for the rest of his life because I'm here as a father. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to leave a legacy. You know what I'm saying? I love doing it. We all love doing it. All comics love doing it, but I think you're supposed to have something to leave something.
Right.
And that's what I'm after.
Right. It's just like musicians leaving a catalog to their children.
Yeah, you have to have a catalog out here, y'all. Two or three shows don't make you famous, okay? I'm just saying. I've been doing this for a minute now. I'm working on a comedy album, too. Wait for that. It's coming out real soon. I got a comedy album for real.
Okay.
Real comedy album is dope. It's going to be dope. So fuck with me. Fuck with me. You know what I'm talking about? I got a new underwear, everything. I'm ready. Right now. For y'all bitches that can get pregnant, I got a condom on, but if you want it, come get it. You know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping 100.
Hey, yo, what was that thing you always talk about? The Cincinnati Bengals, man.
I feel like this. I'm from Cincinnati. I'm supposed to represent everything that got something to do with Natty, but I don't feel that way.
Right.
Because I don't smoke that bout too. I smoke this. I smoke that. The Bengals is only good on PlayStation. Period.
That's it.
Everybody know it. You a Bengals fan?
Nah.
You see, he ain't lose no weight. You see that? This nigga ain't lose a pound at all. So we gotta be honest. You know what I'm talking about? We keeping it 100, 1,000.
But are you winning with Joe Burrow as quarterback on there? Who's the quarterback on PlayStation?
You.
So anybody winning.
Whoever ain't him is winning.
Hey, so. When you moving city to city doing shows, what's some of the weirdest or funniest things you done came across when you were on the road?
Oh, I just lost weight again.
Besides promoters trying to play you on your check.
I hate that. I do. All comedians know we hate that. Just, you hear me? I don't even show my teeth out of town. You see that? Yeah. The weirdest things, it's like most of the time, drunk fans.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like drunk people that be in the audience. Because I done had a whole lady, drunk as hell, come up on the stage and try to take the mic, bro.
Wow.
I tore her ass up, too.
Did you?
Oh, you can't do that. Are you serious right now? No.
She felt like she could do the job.
Man, she tried to take the mic. First of all, let me tell y'all something. I am on YouTube and I got the footage. If y'all think I'm bullshitting, look me up. Dave Dillenger on YouTube. You can find
it. Get over here. Shot in the ass, nigga.
Oh, hell. Wait a minute now. Your ass need a nut, goddamn it. It's your old ass. Don't do that shit. She probably jumped straight off the IV and came in here. I bet you got a pocketbook full of aspirin. If you turn your wig around, you look better. I'm just saying.
Hey, man, you start fucking with me.
First of all, them big ass glasses, you see two niggas up here. Just man, fuck both of y'all. Somebody get Kizzy. Somebody get her, please. Hey, security. Tonight.
I'm so
fresh out the nursing home. Just whose mama is that? I'ma kick her son's ass. I'm telling you.
So man, how can the people get in contact with you? Follow you? You know,
I'm on YouTube, Dave Dillenger. I'm on Facebook, Dave Dillenger. That's about it. Goddamn it, I don't got all that extra shit. You know what I'm saying?
No Instagram, nothing.
I do got Instagram, but it get hacked. Don't use that.
Don't hack.
Fuck around and meet Earl. No. Somebody, I don't know. Do not use that. You know what I'm saying? Go through him, goddammit. Call this nigga right here. Y'all know this nigga. This his page, right? Call him to fuck with me. We straight.
Yeah, no doubt.
Don't use no IG.
It's Dave Dillenger, man.
If this was IG, he'd be like, get Dillenger. Your ass. Don't do that.
No. Hey, bro. It was nice talking to you, bro, man. No doubt, you, man. Dave Dillenger, like I said, man. At an Ovations Entertainment Crew,
yes,
baby.
Sir.
You know what I mean? I'm your boy, Benny Benz, host for The Culture Show. We out, baby.
Benny Benz, yeah. It's The Culture Show.